So we have to solve the problem. And the only way you get to solve the problem is not by deploying thousands, not tens of thousands, eventually millions of systems will move the needle. So you have to address every single barrier. So we got started, just myself, my brother, in his kitchen, and started knocking down the first barriers. Ironically enough, the first barrier was just for a homeowner to be able to call someone. You'd be surprised that 3 years ago, homeowners would not know who to call for a quality solar installation. There weren't any really established companies. So we built that out. But the cost was still big, and the average system was around $30,000. So we said, okay, we've got to do something to reduce the cost. And we started looking at what are the big cost factors. One of the big cost factors was efficiency throughput of our organization, meaning if you go into one area and you install one home, and you come back 3 weeks later, you dispatch someone again to that same area to install a new home, it would have been a lot more efficient to install two homes in that same week. So we launched what we call our community program. But if you get a community to go solar all at once, you can offer them a large discount as the company's efficiency improves. So you're just essentially passing that cost savings back to them. This really worked well. So we launched our first community program in Portola Valley. Then we launched our second one, I think it was actually here in Stanford. And we've launched about 22 or 23 community programs across California and Arizona. But it still had this massive number. So even if we were able to reduce the cost by 10%, you still had homeowners needing to spend about $25,000. So we knew that the way to address that problem is to provide financing. So we try to get financing early on in the process. But when you go to a bank and you say you have this creative idea on how to finance systems, and the bank asks you, so how much money do you need? Your natural intention is to ask for a little, because you don't want to ask for too much. The irony with that is, if you ask for little, they go, it's not worth their time. So we first asked for 5 or 10 million, and we got no, no, no. Then we asked for 100 million, and we got a yes. So, but you had to build the credibility to be able to deploy 100 million. So if we just went out asking for 100 million, that wouldn't have worked either. But through the community programs, building enough scale in the organization, expanding through California, we built enough size to convince the first bank, which happened to be Morgan Stanley, to give us a $100 million fund. That really changed the value proposition to the homeowner.